The following is a presentation of TFNN. The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every business day. Tom takes your phone calls toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Let's go to Alex in Newton. Hey, Alex, what's going on, brother?
Hi, Tom. How are you doing?
I'm doing great, man. Yourself?
I'm doing pretty good.
Good, man.
Subscribe for your gold report. I've been following you for a while. The first time I subscribed for it. And what I love about your gold report is that you give us a direction. You give us an overview of the whole market, and you leave final decision to us because you give a lot of ideas. After that, you can choose what whatever you want to follow, whatever you don't.
Yeah.
That is great.
Okay, brother.
Thank you.
Have a great one, man. Have a safe one.
Thanks.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Hi, welcome to the Tom O'Brien Show. I'm John Logan, filling in for Tom O'Brien today, and you're in for a real treat because I'm doing the first hour. David White's doing the second hour. I always learn something, learn many things when I listen to David White. He's got a great show that he does every afternoon on TFNN right before Tom. I do one in the morning, and that's from 8 to 9. It's called the Global Market Pulse, and we've got to take a look at some of the things that's coming up on this hour. First, Andy Hecht is going to be with us after the first break, and that's going to always be awesome to talk to Andy Hecht, who's giving an incredible series of events here over the week of, and let's just pull up that date, starting on May 4th, every day at 5:30, you got to sign up on the TFNN homepage, and signing up is going to give you access to four different sessions, 2-hour sessions, I might add, from 5:30 to 7:30 every day from May 4th, May 18th, June 1st, and June 15th. He's going to space them out first week of May 4th. So be sure you sign up for that on the homepage of the TFNN website. And we're going to be talking to Andy after the first break. He can kind of go through what the series of events is going to be. I'm going to attend it myself. I always learn something when I listen to Andy's show on TFNN. So let's get back to what we need to talk about today before we bring Andy on in just a couple of minutes. Let's look at the broad market as we look at it with our TAS profile scanner. We're going to look at the net profile breadth statistics, not net profile breadth statistics. And as we look at this, you'll notice that the NASDAQ sitting here got a little bit of destruction in the cell structure here. And what does that mean? As we mouse across these red cells here, we're going to notice that we obviously have clipped below profiles on every time frame, but our breadth has stayed, just hung right in there on the daily positive and the 240s and the weekly. So again, what does this mean? This means that the broad index itself is starting to break these barriers, but the breadth, the internals of that particular index of those 100 NASDAQ stocks is still staying positive. And that means that there's a massive disconnect. I don't even have to know about Apple or Netflix or some of the other stocks that are leading this thing down, Amazon. It's the leaders let it up. The leaders are going to lead it down. So the leaders are a big weight in this particular index itself. I don't have to tell you guys that. Apple, I think, alone is over 13-14% of the value of the index. And when those stocks crack, the index itself is going to come down. And the rest of the internals are basically saying, you know what, we still kind of want to hang in there. So again, we're going to kind of define what that means, but let's go into the charts really quick, and let me repost my chart here. We're going to take a look at the NASDAQ. And as we look at this, we're going to look at our long-term profiles on our weekly first, and we're going to notice this 4508 line in the sand on our weekly combined with this 4440, if you'll notice, we kind of broke down the weekly. Now we're retesting the bottom of the profile on the daily. And what does this all mean? This means that cell structure we talked about earlier, we're below these profiles, weekly, daily, 240 and 60 on down the line when it comes to the index itself. But a lot of the internals of the index, we're going to examine a couple of instruments, and we're going to look at the cell structure across the board of the entire index in a little bit within the scanner and just kind of show you what's holding up, what's not holding up. You're trying to find anomalies in situations like this to try to take advantage of, and hopefully we can find some. So yesterday closed below this daily profile and the weekly profile for that matter, 44.40. And when we look at this retest this morning, this is what you want to really kind of focus on. The close below profiles, go back and retest. Those are the powerful trades. Now, without question, Apple did not help this situation. We're going to review this really quick. And I'm going to go back to the scanner really quick and just show you what Apple looks like within the sell structure here. I'm going to go to the S&P 500 grid. And I hope you guys are still seeing my screen, because when I flip back and forth between these charts and scanner, sometimes we lose it in the din. You'll notice right across the board. What does that mean? That means we're trading below profiles. The current new profile in Apple, that's bad. And that unfair low, 99.80, we were just hoping for a retest of yesterday's kind of flush out action today to get short this around 100, 99.80 to 100. That didn't happen. And is continue to head lower. That's very bearish in itself. But as we look at this sell structure, there has been zero reasons to go long this stock. Zero. And before these earnings, this is a great lesson to not always kind of roll the dice before these earnings, to get out and kind of wait and see what happens and trade the reaction. So as we're looking at our long-term chart on Apple, right before these earnings last week, we had come down right to the precipice, the cliff, on the long-term profiles last week, excuse me. And this week, we're just trading within the balanced area. Now we're below the balanced area. Now you've got big-time resistance around 99.80 or 100. Okay, so as we look at this, what do you do with Apple now? If you're stuck in Apple, sometimes you got to just take the pain, get out, and look for another entry. As you can see now, when we started breaking down below 108.55 and then again 104, sitting at that cliff as the markets continue to kind of gravitate higher, we want to look at these particular indications and try to block out one side of the marketplace, and blocking out the short side has been very appropriate in this case. I think we've got a caller, Ed from Canada. Are you with us? Okay. Ed's not with us. No problem. Thought we had a caller there. So as we look at Apple and we try to block out one side of the marketplace now, you have not a lot of indications here to look at nibbling on Apple from the long side. When we have some new information down here and a new profile appearing on the daily, I don't know if we have the caller or not. We'll figure that out at the break. When we have a new profile attempting to appear on the daily and in force, then you've got a chance to play defense on Apple from the long side. But right now, we're still in free fall, and the situation on Apple is still block out the long side, only look at the short side. I hear the music, guys. We're going to come right back, and we've got a real treat. Andy Heck's going to be with us.
If you're an active trader looking for that extra edge when it comes to trading and investments, then now is a great time to get a 2-week free trial to Tom O'Brien's daily market letter, Market Insights. Tom O'Brien's daily newsletter, Market Insights, comes out every market day at around 9:30 a.m. and provides Tom's daily commentary on the broad market, including the Dow, NASDAQ, and S&P, plus specific trade recommendations. There's even an update published most afternoons to keep you informed about the day's market activity. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock and option trade. With Market Insights, there's nothing left to guessing. For all the details and to get your 2-week free trial to Market Insights started today, visit tfnn.com.
In quiet markets, investors search for new trading opportunities. We'd like to introduce you to a new product that provides opportunities even in flat markets. Nadex, the North American Derivatives Exchange, is a new and innovative Chicago-based exchange registered with the Commodity Futures Trading Commission, and unlike most other exchanges, Nadex allows you to trade directly through them with direct market access when using their trading platform. Nadex never charges a fee to use their platform, which even includes real-time charts and full customization capability. Nadex's unique short-term binary options allow traders and investors to capitalize on strategies even when the underlying markets are quiet. Nadex's innovation has allowed them to come up with a line of unique trading products that are unavailable anywhere else. See how it works at Nadex.com. That's Nadex.com, or click on the Nadex banner on the front page of TFNN.com. Futures and options trading involves risk and may not be appropriate for all investors. Until recently, it was almost impossible for the average investor to hedge against currency risk in Europe or Japan. For a bold trade on Europe or Japan that protects against moves in currency, trade HEGE or HEGJ, two times currency-hedged, leveraged ETFs from Direction Investments. Visit directioninvestments.com today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Tom, take your phone calls now. Toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Hi, guys. Welcome back to the Tom O'Brien Show. I'm John Logan filling in for Tom today, and David White's going to be doing the next hour. You're going to thoroughly enjoy that. But right now, we are lucky enough to have Andy Hecht with us. Andy, are you there?
Hey, how are you?
Good, man. What's going on?
Good to talk to you.
Yeah.
It's been a while. You know, you're always on too early for me here since I'm out here on the West Coast.
Well, that means you got to get up at 4 a.m, Andy.
I know. I do. Once in a while I do and I tune in, but, you know, I do need my beauty rest, especially with this mug, you know. So listen, I think we're seeing some really interesting things going on in markets here. And I think that once again, the Federal Reserve lit the fuse in the commodity markets yesterday.
Oh, my God, did they ever.
Oh, my God. You know, inaction, they get more done by doing nothing than anyone. But it's just amazing. So we're seeing the dollar, you know, coming down. It's going to come up to some really important support levels, the 92.50 level, which was the August 24th lows. That was the day that the Chinese government devalued the yuan.
Got it.
And look. Bullish key reversal today in gold, made a lower low, slightly lower low than yesterday, and now we are on the highs of the day, up at 1268. Looks like we're going after that 1288 high, and above there, you know, we're looking at about 1308, which is last January's high. Silver just exploding here as well. 1762, we're 15 cents off the July highs dating back to April 21st. We go through there, it looks like it's going to 18 and a half bucks. So, you know, go ahead, sorry.
This one seems like the real indicator to me, silver, because this thing, I mean, you've got a better opinion and outlook on this probably than I do, because I don't really trade silver. It's been dormant forever, but all this, I mean, can you kind of elaborate on that? Like, why do you think?
Absolutely.
This thing is, go
ahead. So let's take a look. Let's take a look at the silver gold ratio. All right. I have a chart up there of the silver gold ratio.
Okay.
Now, you know, this thing goes back to 3000 BC, John. The first Egyptian pharaoh, Menes, said, he wrote that 2.5 parts silver equal 1 part gold. So that's the first, you know, recorded. You know, gold and silver have been money for forever. I'm 56 years old. I remember when I was a kid, my grandfather, he used to call the change in his pocket silver. You know?
It's, got it. Yep.
Because it was like, you know, gold is the bill, silver is the change. But silver is a highly speculative, highly volatile commodity. It's poor man's gold. So when the precious metals come back, people tend to flock to silver because it's a lot easier to shell out $17 an ounce today than it is to shell out, you know, almost $1,300 an ounce.
I hear you.
So we saw in February the silver gold ratio go to 83 to 1, or 83 ounces of silver value in each ounce of gold value. And that was the highest level in 21 years since 1995. Over the last 40 years, it's traded as high as almost 100 to 1 and as low as 16 to 1. So it has turned around, as you can see on this chart, and now right. We're down below 72 to 1. And I always look, a falling silver-gold ratio is a bullish validation for the precious metal sector. So I was a little confused early in the year when this thing was widening and going higher and gold was going higher. But now we're back into a mode where, you know, this is highly supportive for precious metals. Let's look at another one here,
okay. Which
is platinum versus gold. And we can see here that relationship, before 2015, the highest gold premium to platinum that I ever saw was a $200 premium gold over platinum. The long-term norm for platinum, which is often called rich man's gold, mm-hmm. is $200 premium to the price of gold. So we went in February to $320 discount, which is a huge divergence from the norm. We have since gone down. Today we're at $215 discount platinum under gold. And platinum, if I put a platinum chart up here, platinum's breaking out here today. So, you know, like I said, the Fed lit the fuse. It's not just precious metals. Let's look at crude oil. Crude oil, we're trading at the highest level since last year. This is the highest level of 2016. Let's look at soybeans. I mean, there's some fundamental things going on in the soybean market. Certainly, you know, the crop is lower because of floods in Brazil
right. And
a drought in Brazil, rather, and floods in Argentina. But today, soybeans put up a new high. Corn is being dragged along, and that's kind of in bullish mode. And even wheat, which is suffering from massively high inventories, is moving higher. You know, so if we look at all these things, and even I'll even throw up some esoterics, cotton is moving higher, and lumber since the Fed meeting has moved higher and regained the bull. So you're seeing a real inflationary kind of pickup here.
Do you think? Andy, do you think we've already had, because a lot of the folks out there are probably going, well, wow, should I just get in there and get these, hang on, you know, go ahead and accumulate some of these commodities and hang on for the ride. And a lot of times these commodity rides, as you know, just insane, the moves that they can make. But do you kind of wait for pullbacks on these or maybe a new?
Yes, absolutely. Listen, okay. I never buy new highs in these markets. These markets are highly volatile. Let's put up the soybean chart for a minute. That gives you a great example of what happened. You know, we had a big move up on April 21st. It went in a straight line. It went up to like 1043 a bushel. You know, the next day we were down at 988. There is huge volatility. So you got to buy weakness in these markets, days where there are pullbacks. You know, this is absolutely key because buying highs is always a recipe for disaster. But, you know, I kind of like the whole sector. And what I think, John, is we've gone from 4 years where the right trade was to sell every rally and buy back on dips at new lows to buying dips and selling on rallies and selling new highs, taking profits there. So we kind of have to change our mindset.
Yeah, I tend to agree with that. I mean, there's been a sea change of events going on. Do you think the dollar's going to continue to get weaker and kind of help this cause? Or what's your thoughts there?
You know, I mean, I was so bullish on the dollar until earlier this year. I loved that trend from May 2014 through March, you know, through the beginning of 2016. But when the Fed reneged on its promise to raise interest rates early in the year, it said to me, hey, something's going on here. So I got out of my long dollar positions. When the Japanese central bank, you know, cut rates further into negative territory, and the yen rallied, when the euro, when Draghi fired a bazooka at the European economy and the euro rallied, it said to me, hey, game over for the dollar. And I think that the dollar, listen, 92.5 is a key level. Could we get a bounce here? Yes. Will that cause commodities to backtrack? Probably. But we're going after that 92.5 level. If we break through there and we, you know, we could go very quickly lower. And hey, what's a 50% retracement of the move from 79 roughly to 100 is around 90. That could be in the cards.
Andy, can you stay with us? I want to like kind of talk about your event coming up in the
sure.
the series. Okay, great. Absolutely. Guys, we'll be right back.
Tom O'Brien's weekly gold letter, The Gold Report, gives complete and concise coverage of the entire gold market. Inside, you'll get Tom's commentary on gold, the dollar, the rand, the bond, the XAU, the HUI, and detailed coverage of nearly 25 mining stocks. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock trade. The Gold Report is a long-term newsletter where the focus is on building real wealth through the management of a successful portfolio of gold stocks. With a lifetime of knowledge and almost 12 years of writing his informative weekly newsletter, The Gold Report, Tom O'Brien can provide you with the important market information to help you make better trades in the gold market. Don't let the next bull run in gold pass you by. To get a month-long free trial to The Gold Report, an $85 value, visit the front page of TFNN.com today.
If you're looking to discover a new financial resource and diversify your financial portfolio, don't miss out on the Market Safe Commodity Solution CD from EverBank. This is the second running of their popular 5-year U.S. dollar-denominated CD, which gives you exposure to 8 equally weighted commodities, including WTI crude oil, gold, silver, copper, nickel, soybeans, corn, and sugar. With annual pricing caps of 70% per component, you could earn up to 70% upside payment at maturity if the commodities increase in value across annual pricing dates. And should the opposite occur, your principal is 100% protected. Keep in mind, returns are based on CD performance. There's no annual percentage yield or periodic rate of interest on this indexed CD. Don't miss out. Take advantage of this financial resource designed to grow with the times. The May 19th funding deadline is quickly approaching. So hurry over to everbank.com/TFNN for the CD's term sheet and other important product details and disclosures. Once again, that's everbank.com/TFNN. This advertisement is sponsored content. EverBank is a member. FDIC.
Hi, I'm Steve Rhodes, host of The Trader's Edge, heard daily at TFNN.com and author of Mastering Probability, a daily investment and trading newsletter service that I send out each morning by 8 a.m. My morning newsletter service covers exactly what the markets have been doing since last night's close, providing you with an edge on your trading day ahead. You get actionable trading ideas, including the exact entry, stop, and profit targets. Plus, I'll teach you the patterns and hidden market correlations that will make you a better trader. As a subscriber, you'll gain access to my 90-minute money management workshop, where I'll teach you the secrets that'll save your assets. The bottom line, I've got your back, including a 30-day money-back guarantee. See for yourself the type of analysis I provide each trading day by signing up for Mastering Probability today. With nothing to lose, this is an offer you should not pass on. Mastering Probability can be found under trading newsletters on the front page of TFNN.com.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Hi, guys. Welcome back to the show, The Tom O'Brien Show. I'm John Logan filling in for Tom today, and we are honored to have Andy Hecht on with us. And Andy, can we talk a little bit about the 12 Essential Lessons for Trading Commodities series that you're doing soon? Because I want to attend this more than anybody else.
Let me tell you what I'm doing. First of all, just to give you a little background, you know, when I graduated from school back in 1980, I had a choice. I got into law school, And I also got offered a job at Philip Brothers, which was one of the, I had worked there in the summers, which was at the time the largest physical commodity trading house in the world. And I decided that, you know, I went to school in London my last year of school, and I decided that I wanted every day in my life to be different. And I wanted a global view. It really opened, a boy from Brooklyn, it opened my eyes to the world out there. And the commodities business is such a global business. So, you know, I started in 1980, and I've been doing this now for, I mean, you know, 36 years and looking at these markets. And I worked with some of the most interesting characters in the world and learned a lot about economics, a lot about politics, and a lot about commodities. So what I tried to do in this course that I've put together for TFNN listeners called the 12 Essential Lessons for Trading Commodities is to really kind of delve down deep into these commodity markets. And what we're doing is we're going to do it over four sessions starting next Wednesday, May 4th. Each session is going to be 2 hours, and in each session I'm going to do three lessons. They're about 35 minutes each. Like, for example, I'm going to start the course off with kind of background, commodity markets and demographics. It's really the demand side and the trends on the demand side. Then I'm going to look at the breakdown of the markets, which is physical versus derivatives. You know, John, commodities are like a pyramid, and at the top of that pyramid is the physical. And all of these things that we trade, these trading sardines like futures and options and swaps and ETFs and ETNs, they all try to replicate what goes on in the physical. So we're going to go through that so people can get a good understanding, students can get a good understanding of the derivative markets versus what they're trying to replicate. Then we're going to look at market structure. That's the first course. Then we'll go deeply into backwardation and contango and how to look at those market structures to tell us something about supply and demand. We're going to look at term structure, processing spreads. That'll be on the May 18th session. Then on June 1st, we're going to look at location spreads because commodities are like real estate. It's all about location, location, location in terms of value. And then we'll look at real value, which is intercommodity spreads, which tells us about value rather than price. Then we're going to look at quality spreads, the difference between things like gold that's a certain fineness and gold that's another fineness, or Robusta coffee versus Arabica coffee, or Brent crude versus WTI crude. And then finally, on June 15th, we'll wrap up the course with three lessons. The technical indicators that I look at, which are different than a lot of other technicians in terms of the herd in commodities, options data, not options prices, but what option data can tell you in terms of the different types of volatility and in terms of looking at the markets. And finally, these new products, the ETFs and ETNs, and what those flows can tell us about the pyramid and what's going on in the markets. So that's it in a nutshell.
Well, you know what? I want to make just a note of what you said. There's a couple of topics that I think are just completely invaluable for somebody to know about if they're trading these underlying commodities, because you can look at charts and you can kind of listen to the news, whatever. But if you don't know the mechanics of the internals, like you're going to talk about in the backwardation versus contango and things like that, to where there may be some great spreading opportunities that are really high risk reward situations.
Oh,
that,
absolutely. You know,
aren't really available just kind of focusing on the price of the commodity. And those are the types of things that, you know, you listen to some of the things you will say about this and those topics, you can't understand how powerful that is to even have that in the hard drive back there, you know, in your head, where you're just, they're kind of on the radar screen and you're just, man, I'm looking forward to this, Andy, so
absolutely.
Much.
You know what, John? The most important thing for me, when I always talk, when I lectured last week, I was in Denver, and I actually teach at the University of Colorado Denver Business School, and I mostly teach people in industry and a lot of post-master students. And the one thing that I really try to get through to them is that there's a big difference between price and value. And in terms of investing or trading, understanding value is really important. And that's something that I really try to drive home. And the other thing I do in the course is I tell a lot of stories about physical trades that I did that really concrete, that make a lot of the concepts more concrete.
Well, I tell you what, I'm looking forward to it. I hope everybody out there can get signed up for it because, you know, having that type of knowledge, again, in the back of your head of it, you know, and being able to kind of look at some of these markets, keeping that in mind and understanding when these, you know, possible spreading opportunities or when to stay out of the market altogether.
Because absolutely.
Something's looking a little wacky. You know, these are just incredible things to be aware of.
Absolutely. Hey, I have a question for you. A quick question for you.
Yeah.
So how much would the market be down today if the Facebook earnings weren't what they were?
Oh, my goodness. Yeah.
It would be ugly, wouldn't it?
Very ugly. Let's.
Hey, by the way, that's another thing that's telling us that the Fed, I don't know if the Fed is dry. You know, I look at the Fed, you know, and monetary authorities, it's like a horse in a cart. I think the Fed is like in the cart. They're not driving the horse here. I think the Fed is actually reacting to markets, whereas it should be the other way around.
There's no doubt about that. We've been talking about that on my show for a while, and it's just it's incredible how, yeah, the Fed now's. They think their job, I guess, is just to prop the market up, and that always is going to end terribly.
Ooh, that's going to end in tears, man.
It's very difficult to time that, Andy, as you know. Like, when does this kind of come up? When did the hinges fly off? But I mean, the Nasdaq has just really technically had some damage on the index itself. The internals really haven't kind of arbitraged themselves together yet, but I feel like that's coming.
I agree, and I think that anyone who's still in like some of these NASDAQ stocks, they should kiss the ground and thank Facebook, and here's an opportunity to flatten out.
Yeah, exactly. That's, you know, like the bean trade. You know, it's like people are talking about, you know, hey, you've got an opportunity to still kind of get out of this kind of tech thing that might actually start having some issues. You know, beans went straight up and kind of gave you a chance. If you're looking at shorting those at all, I don't know why you'd do that, but it kind of had a decent pull. I think it was 40 or 50 cent pullback in right. 24 hours.
Right.
And then we kind of got away from that area and just started rallying again. I mean, that might be the last time to get out of a short trade for that in a while.
Let me say one thing about commodities here. One of the most telling things that's going on is if you ever look at the Baltic Dry Index, mm-hmm. I mean, you don't trade this thing, but you got to look at it. Mm-hmm. It has gone from 290 on February 11th to 715 today.
Incredible.
That says it all, because
incredible.
That tells you that economic activity, shipping of bulk commodities is picking up. We've seen it in iron ore. We've seen it in steel. Listen, we're seeing it in gold. We're seeing it in oil. These right. are important things, and these are inflationary. And my biggest worry, and probably the biggest worry for the central banks, is stagflation. You have, you know, lower economic activity and higher inflation. That's a nightmare.
Well, Andy, thanks for coming on. We look forward to the 12 essential lessons for trading commodities you're going to do, and I'll talk to you again soon.
Excellent. I'll be back at 5.
Great, great. Cool.
TFNN is excited to offer a brand new piece of market scanning software unlike anything the industry has ever seen. John Logan and his team have spent years developing their market profile tools to finally be able to release the TAS Profile Scanner Plus. And right now, you can get a 2-week trial absolutely free just by visiting TFNN.com and providing us your name and email address. The TAS Profile Scanner Plus is the premier market profile-based scanner in the industry. Powered by the acclaimed TAS proprietary algorithms, this feature-rich scanner is a standalone desktop software that instantly filters over 2,500 global financial markets such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Within 3 minutes of signing up, you can have the software downloaded and running on your computer with a complete roadmap of market indicators and inflection points to trade off using the TAS Profile Scanner Plus. Sign up today and try this amazing piece of software by visiting TFNN.com. Tiger Real Estate Opportunity Fund is currently offering 4-year first mortgages on many of the fully renovated properties that it has purchased. The first mortgages are third-party appraised with a maximum loan-to-value ratio of 70%, providing a secured investment that pays a fixed return of 5% annually, which works out to a monthly income of more than $416 per $100,000 investment with your principal intact and secured. These 4-year first mortgages are perfect for anyone looking for a secured investment that provides monthly income much like a CD. For more information, email tigerfund@tfnn.com or click on the Tiger Real Estate Opportunity Fund banner along the right side of the tfnn.com homepage or call our office directly at 877-518-9190. There's a limited supply, so act now. The Path of Least Resistance is David White's daily trading newsletter, and if you're looking for active trading ideas, then now's a perfect time for a 30-day free trial to this powerful daily trading advisory service. David uses his years of trading experience to offer his subscribers his trading ideas each morning in his Path of Least Resistance newsletter. Using a combination of equity trades along with options, David keeps his subscribers up to date with all pertinent market information with intraday afternoon updates when warranted. Don't miss out on this great chance to get a 30-day free trial to David's daily newsletter, The Path of Least Resistance, with no obligation to pay anything. David has been delivering solid recommendations for his subscribers recently, and if you'd like to see the type of newsletter he delivers every morning, then visit the front page of TFNN, and you'll find The Path of Least Resistance under Trading Newsletters. For all the details and to start your 30-day free trial today, log on to TFNN.com now.
Tom, take your phone calls now. Toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Tom O'Brien.
Hi, guys. Welcome back to the show. I'm John Logan, filling in for Tom O'Brien today. And Andy Heck, just always a pleasure to have him on. Just a book of knowledge when it comes to trading commodities. And he's doing a Again, 12 essential lessons for trading commodities starting May 4th, carrying through all the way to June 15th. Get signed up on the homepage of TFN. You won't regret it. We've got David White next hour, going to do the next hour for the Tom O'Brien Show. And if you can stay tuned for that, you will learn something. David is extremely prepared. He does a show every day from 2 to 3. And I always learn something listening to his show. I always pick something up. So tell you what, we talked about Apple a little bit. Let's just go into our charts here, if I can get this scanner minimized. Let's take a look at, you know, we had a question earlier about Apple. Let's just kind of stay on this because this is, to some degree, some of the driving force behind the NASDAQ. And again, Andy was spot on talking about Netflix kind of saved the day for the index itself. You just don't get that sometimes. We could have been down. Dow's down 211 now. Is that right? Ooh, okay. Had a little bit of a move while we've been on the air here. You know, Apple, I was just praying that we'd get a retracement back up into that 99.80, 100 to whack this thing again on the short side. Now we're trading 94, 95 down in there. Market's coming around on the downside. I was just kind of shocked. I'm on the currency screen here. Let me go back to my Facebook. I'm sorry, not Netflix. Facebook. My bad. Thanks for correcting me in the den. I had my mouse on Facebook and somehow said Netflix. So here's the S&Ps. I want to pull up the NASDAQ really quick. Now, we were talking about the internals of what was going on with the NASDAQ, looking at the scanner and talking earlier this hour about the breakdown of the index itself, getting below this 4508, 4440. And actually getting a gift or tracing back up into that line in the sand on the daily 44.40 this morning, and then just getting, you know, just coming unglued on the downside here. And it was weird how the internals of the, you know, and the breadth indications on the scanner, they weren't, things were kind of disconnected. And I was like, wow, this has got to kind of arbitrage itself together. Well, we're getting that sell off now. And if we look at the scanner and go back into our indices profile heat grid and look at the breadth calculations that are going on. Looking at our daily now, NASDAQ now breadth, daily's turned over, weekly's kind of still hanging in there, but man, this is now looking heavy across the board, deep red here, all sells red, and the breadth now is starting to roll here. That means more stocks are trading below profiles than above profiles. And when we look at the S&Ps here, breadth is still kind of positive on the daily, but again, some of the shorter terms have turned negative. And we talked about a trade on the S&Ps, I think I was during the webinar, talking about getting, that I did a couple of weeks or a week or two ago, 2095, 2096 being that line in the sand and being able to, you know, what do you do? Try not to get shaken out of this trade. Some things were, you know, starting to look a little heavy here around the top of the profile. And now we're trading 25, 30 points below there. And that we had suggested a type of trade where you've got unlimited upside and a very limited downside, but needing a big move for this to work out. We talked about shorting the index itself and going long in the money calls as a hedge. And that now is kind of, again, unraveling. The VIX is increasing. Those calls are continuing to hold their value. And by the way, if you're thinking about putting on some, you know, this isn't a real sophisticated hedge strategy, but every day at lunch, Think or Swim, they do an hour on option strategies. And do yourself a favor, pipe into that, keep it in the background. You'll really learn about how to put on some very mitigating risk type strategies like the one I just said by listening to Mr. Hinks from Thinkorswim and a couple of his partners who put on a great show at lunch. All right, let's take a look at Facebook. And even Facebook is coming off the highs here. Still incredibly powerful move after the announcement here. So now, what do you do with Facebook in the midst of all the things going on with the NASDAQ and Apple falling out of bed? 113.64 is that pullback retracement area for Facebook. If the NASDAQ continues to drag and the S&Ps kind of start following suit here, which it seems like that's what's happening, you're going to have a really nice opportunity that possibly kind of rising tides lifts all boats, and in this case, lowering tides beach boats. I don't know what the opposite of that is, but you got a chance for Facebook to actually come back. After the breakout, Andy was talking about not trying to buy the high print on these things that are just, you know, going parabolic. You're going to get pullbacks. So that pullback, 113.64, is going to be that inflection point to pay attention to. So, you know, keep your skirt on when it comes to this and going long. You got some lower opportunities here and really a nice dig-in area between 113.64 and about 114.5. So that would be the place to look at that. Now, if the market continues to come unglued, it may drag this thing down farther. But again, I think, you know, you kind of got all-time highs going on here. You got some people wanting to take something off the table. But if we hold up around that area, this will be one of those kind of let's find strong stocks in a market that's pulling back. This would obviously be one to look at. All right, let's take a look at Netflix because I had somehow mentioned this as Facebook earlier. You know, some of these stocks, again, you know, when we had the news on Netflix come out and just completely getting below 103.17, we never got a retracement back up into that area. That's the bottom of our profile. That's the technical damage on the intermediate. A lot of the leaders have technical damage. And, you know, some of these disconnects between the leaders were dragging this thing up. Now there's going to be some arbitrage type situations going on. The internals are going to, the rest of the pack is going to go, whoa, okay, I need to kind of self-adjust reversion to the mean type situation here. And, you know, this is kind of what's unfolding this afternoon. So as we look at this, we're going to go back to, I'm going to give some updates on some, these are futures, real-time futures indices up or down. The Dow's down 212 on the futures now. The NASDAQ's down 64 points on the futures. The S&Ps now are eclipsing down 20 on the day. So, again, this is something that we were expecting. I was expecting this to happen a lot sooner than this, but now you've got the breadth calculations that we use coinciding with what that kind of, you know, hey, let's kind of everybody get back together and get, you know, understand that, you know, these things can't stay separated. We talked on my show a little bit about 2059, 2060 as the targets, initial targets on this move down. I'm not so sure we're going to actually hold up there, but that's our targets on the initial move down from 2096, 2097. All right. So that's the situation on the S&P futures. The dollar is really getting hit here. Even making new lows as we do the show here, getting below these 94 general neighborhood areas on the M4 lows on the weekly and the daily. And if I go into the scanner and I look at my futures section, I can quickly see going down to the dollar. We're right across the board here now, too. So those commodity prices that Andy was talking about, this weaker dollar, by all means, is going to help that situation. Guys, we'll be right back.
Larry Pesavento has just started his brand new service, Fibonacci 24/7, and he's already delivering content to his subscribers on a daily basis when the market's opened and even on weekends. Each Monday, you'll receive Larry's written report that provides detailed commentary and a summary on the charts and videos that Larry sends out. And throughout the week, when warranted, Larry will send out via charts or videos or both the key markets that he is watching during the day. This will be up-to-the-date active trading information that will help you in your daily trading. In Larry's first week alone, he sent out 25 charts, 6 videos, and a full report to his subscribers in just 1 week. If you're a technical trader that uses patterns and retracements to trade, then Larry's service Fibonacci 24/7 is something that you must try. Right now, new subscribers can get a full 30-day money-back guarantee. With nothing to risk, sign up now to Larry Pesavento's Fibonacci 24/7 by visiting the front page of TFNN.com under Trading Newsletters. Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion. While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a 2-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your 2-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, The Opening Call, today by visiting TFNN.com. TFNN is excited about our new software charting program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan thousands of stocks for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, ABC's, Butterflies, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the markets for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, or even months searching to find. And right now, we're offering licenses available at only $79 a month. We are so confident that you're going to love this new charting software that will even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Get your copy of The Art of Timing the Trade Charts today by visiting TFNN.com.
This segment is brought to you by TFNN. Test drive all the newsletters for free at TFNN.com.
Hi, guys. Welcome back to the Tom O'Brien Show. I'm John Logan filling in for Tom today. And you're going to be in for a real treat. David White is going to do the next hour. Stay tuned for that if you can. You will thoroughly enjoy it. Looking at Amazon right now, again, some news coming out. A lot of these stocks, wow, man, look at these dailies. I mean, just breaking below profiles for the first time. And this is a company that, man, does a lot of business, but makes about 0.01 something percent profits on what they do. I still haven't understood that model. But 615.16 is the resistance area on that. That's the big inflection point. Any retracements back up into there more than likely need to be sold. But again, let things, as Tom would say, shake out a little bit first. Trade the reaction, not the initial action. Those are usually the things where the electronic automation arbitrage machines and everything else that's going on kind of get out of the way, and then not the smart money, but the larger money comes into play, and that's where you can kind of take a look at things a little bit differently. Let's take a look at the S&Ps again, coming off another 4 points since we've been talking in the last update, down 20. So the thing that's really cool right now is I'm going to go back to the scanner. I'm going to look at these S&Ps, and the breadth is still hanging in on the daily, but some of these shorter terms have crossed over. Now, I like to see at least one of those weekly or daily breadth crossovers start to be negative. We're near kind of highs up here, and we're just coming off this weekly for high around 2095, 2096. This would lend credence to having some more legs on the downside, but remember, inflection points are inflection points, and this profile, this daily kind of regulating this trend up, has been a nice little feature, as you can see on the charts here. And in 2060, if you got some shorts on this, you got to take something off down here, because again, this is a major inflection point. And I would, you know, really, you know, Amazon's going to kind of tell the tale in a little while for some other type of herky-jerky moves here. But tomorrow morning, and by all means, a weekly close below 2060 is going to be really, really a stake in the ground, especially with that daily breadth possibly rolling over to negativity. That would be time to look at this from, hey, we may have some continuation on the downside, and let's look at 2060 at that point to sell any type of rallies if we get that type of setup. So, again, that's the take on the index itself, on the S&Ps specifically. NASDAQ has already kind of had its spine broken, so to speak, and retested that 4440. If you've been listening earlier, you know that already. So, again, there's the picture on that. And, again, we don't have any new profiles attempting to appear. We don't have any new profiles attempting to appear on Apple. So, again, I think you're taking your portfolio in your own hands, trying to bottom fish down here with nothing to play defense against. That's what we talk about a lot on the show. It's you know, it's pretty boring to possibly always talk, oh, where do we play defense first? Where do we play defense first? That's the way you are able to take your ball home every day and come back and play again the next day. You play defense, all right? That's how you just continue to churn things out and not try to swing for the fence or think that the market's gone too low or too high. So Apple, let it fall. If you're thinking about trying to pick this thing up on sale, you will have a place to play defense at some point. But right now, 100 is a huge number that it's broken down below. All right. Looking at the den, see if we got any questions. Nope. Got about 20 seconds left. We're going to take a look at Facebook again since we're closing the show. Again, the big numbers here continues to slide. 113.64 into 114.89. That will be the collection point on Facebook. Guys, stay tuned. David White's next. It's been my pleasure. We'll pick it up again tomorrow morning at 8 o'clock on my show.
The following is a presentation of TFNN. The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every business day. Tom takes your phone calls toll-free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Let's go to Kevin in Orlando. Hey, Kevin, what's going on?
Hey, I'm doing great. You know, I am addicted to TFNN.
We appreciate you growling and prowling with us out here. It's a great network, man. And I want to thank everyone out there, you know, for making it a great network.
Well, it's great because I do outside sales, so I get to have the station on my phone the whole day. And when I go pick up the kids from school at 3 o'clock, they all love and give the old ram. Educating the kids at a young age is a good thing.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
And welcome all. This is Dave White sitting in for the one and only Tom O'Brien. We'll be going through lots of earnings tonight, and Tom will be back tomorrow. What do we have? Of course, if you're new and listened to me never, I come on between the 2 and 3 p.m. You can always catch my show, The Power Trading Hour, then. Of course, a lot of action today. Depending on whether you were around at the open, at noon, or a little after 2, you would have seen several different markets, almost a Sybil had all the different personalities. Although I think that that actually proved to be a fraud. I can't remember now. Anyway, we had a sibyl of a market out here today. Many different personalities. Open lower, they pushed the market higher most of the day, got to 2099 on the S&P cash. Rolled over about 2 o'clock. They decided to blame it on Carl Icahn and the sell of Apple shares, but I'm not exactly sure that that had it. The market looked extremely weak to me when I was on the air between 2 and 3, and it looked like it was ready to roll already. As we get to the markets, we'll do a little wrap-up here. We were off 20 on the S&P cash after being up to 2099 and tapping on the door of 2100. The NASDAQ was off 58 after a huge move by, of course, Facebook. Dow was off a 207. I can't remember how much it was, what the high was today. And let me take a quick look. I don't know if that was, where is that? There it is. We got to 18,035. So what are we calling? We're going to call it a 200 some plus point range throughout the day. And gold was up strong. That had a lot to do with the Bank of Japan pulling the football away from a lot of Forex traders who thought they were going to devalue. In retrospect, everybody said, well, they can't do it in front of that G7 or G20 conference coming up here in a week. They'll wait until that happens, and then they will spike the punch bowl. Crude at 45.71. Nat gas was down 4%. So what do we end up with a volume? Well, normally you're listening to Tom O'Brien today, and you think, what's volume? Well, I use the New York Consolidated Tape, which is the New York Stock Exchange, all the shares traded on any ECN, Electronic Commerce Network, and including the Amex Exchange 2, that came out to 4.2 billion shares. To break through the highs, we probably should have been in the 4.8 to 5.2 range, so we were about 25% light yet again today. And that's just trying to match previous volumes at that and at those highs. But it's been kind of an interesting day. If you listen to my show, you know how much I like history. The stock market is basically whatever's happened before will happen again. And we look at those patterns to redo it. It's the same way in history.
And it's all just a little bit of history repeating.
It is, and on this day in 1942, World War II bear market hits its bottom as the Dow Jones Industrial Average closes at 92.92, down almost 1 point for the day and 16.3% for the year to date. Over the next 4 years, the market more than doubles. And, you think we had tough times. I can imagine looking at the stock market at 1942 on this day and seeing that... there's only up from here. Of course, a great deal happening. We'll get into earnings as they come out. Amazon beat. It was up 12%, something like that. LinkedIn is beat up about 15%. Expedia up about 10%. A lot of those companies had some pretty heavy shorts, and if they didn't drop the chalupa on earnings, we're going to pop up a little bit. My guess is we probably will have a little higher opening tomorrow, but the vast amount of stocks, we'll get into them during the show tonight, having a weakness, the most well-known stocks pretty much having some bounces like Facebook. Of course, Apple really taking it out later in the day. We'll say why I have AI informed you thusly on it, but Carl Icahn was selling his shares and that put a little bit more pressure on Apple. The reason why he's selling his shares, though, is something I've brought up for years, and we will continue in on that. In the morning, Monster Beverage, though, Phillips 66, Royal Caribbean Cruise, Seagate Technologies, of course, Western Digital after the bell tonight. We'll look at that. Tyco International also. And after the bell tonight, of course, we did have Amazon. Amgen, I think, is out already. Baidu, Expedia up, Flextronics, Gilead, Groupon, Hartford, Juniper Networks is going to be out. LinkedIn is out and up. Outerwall, Pandora, Select Comfort, Skyworks Solutions, Trimble Navigation, VeriSign, Western Digital, and Wynn Resorts. So we've got a great deal of stuff to cram in to a very short 1 hour. But I will get to the Carl Icahn story, which I think kind of was able to put a little pressure on this market going into the close. And I have to give you one of these.
I informed you thusly.
I did. And what Carl had to say today was it's the attitude of the Chinese government. And I've been talking about this for 2 years. The Chinese have no concept of giving anybody else any money. There's been a lot of discussion politically over the last year about what is fair trade. I can guarantee you I've been there. They have one thought, and that is to win. They don't have any idea of fair play or how to get along with anybody. They're out to win. They are like the probably the best race car drivers. Horrible, horrible people. Nobody, you know, maybe you want to meet them once, but if you're a friend of them, you'll always get the short end of the stick, and that's pretty much the way it is. They are the ultimate capitalists. After coming out of a communist regime, they have absolutely zero desire. But there was also a lot of overselling for Apple. Apple had this idea that everybody was going to own an iPhone. We went through it yesterday after their earnings. And we've got countries like India where a iPhone would be 25% of their entire earnings for the year on average. Even in China, it would be a tenth of their earnings for the entire year. Apple decided to try to get around this in both India and China and got pushed out. They did this by trying to sell the used iPhones that got traded in here in the United States over there at a discounted price. The Chinese government, the Indian government, didn't like it either. There is no free trade when you get over there. Icahn is just coming to that, which I have talked about for years. We'll be back in a minute.
If you're an active trader looking for that extra edge when it comes to trading and investments, then now is a great time to get a 2-week free trial to Tom O'Brien's daily market letter, Market Insights. Tom O'Brien's daily newsletter, Market Insights, comes out every market day at around 9:30 a.m. and provides Tom's daily commentary on the broad market, including the Dow, NASDAQ, and S&P, plus specific trade recommendations. There's even an update published most afternoons to keep you informed about the day's market activity. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock and option trade. With Market Insights, there's nothing left to guessing. For all the details and to get your 2-week free trial to Market Insights started today, visit TFNN.com.
Has the current market volatility continued to stop you out of trades when the market spikes against you? Now is the perfect time to open up an account with Nadex. Nadex, the North American Derivatives Exchange, is a brand new, completely regulated Chicago-based exchange, and unlike most other exchanges, Nadex allows you to trade directly through them with direct market access when using their completely free trading platform, which also features real-time charts and full customization capability. One of the advantages of trading with Nadex in volatile markets is that your risk is always capped and you have the ability of keeping your trades open even when the market spikes against you. Nadex is completely brand new with a line of unique trading products that are unavailable anywhere else. See how it works at Nadex.com. That's Nadex.com. Or click on the Nadex banner on the front page of TFNN.com. Futures and options trading involves risk and may not be appropriate for all investors. Are China A shares hot or not? If you trade China A-shares, now may be time to take a closer look. Trade CHAU or CHAD, Direction's daily CSI 300 China A-share bull and bear ETFs. China A-shares in either direction. Visit directioninvestments.com today.
An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Tom, take your phone calls.
Now.
Toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
And welcome back. This is Dave White sitting in for the one and only Tom O'Brien. If you missed the opening, just getting in your car now. The S&P was off 20, the NASDAQ off 58, the Dow off 207. Gold came in at 1271, crude 4571. After hours, we've got Amazon, and it's up almost 12%. The last was 673. Gilead up, or excuse me, down 5%. Last was 91.69. Expedia up 10%. Last on that was 118.23. LinkedIn Corporation, of course, last was 133, and that's up about 9%. A lot of these had some fairly decent short selling into today and the last couple of days after a lot of people had missed earnings. And, of course, I stay away from earnings. Anyway, we're going to go to Steve in Boston. How are you doing today, Steve?
Very well, thank you.
What would you like to talk about today?
The stock symbol VALE.
Mm-hmm.
Whether it's a good entry point?
Well, this has a beautiful confluence level set up, and that level would be $4.52 to $4.68. So, you know, you get a nice pullback. Not only do you have that confluence level, which is a combination of two different Fibonacci retracement levels, the 618 of one and the 382 of the other, you have a double gap. The first time that gap happened on 3/8, so March the 8th, the next time it gapped up through that exact same price point on April the 11th, you got some fairly decent volume there at 50 million, almost 50 million shares. So you got a bunch of things pointing right at that 452 to 468 level. If it would pierce that, come back in there and close the day back in that range or above it, that would be a beautiful sign to get back in it. Of course, it has to come back down there with a light volume.
Okay, so at this point, then, it'd be better not to enter it.
No, I wouldn't be chasing anything. In fact, I'm 100% short the market today. We've been adding positions for the last week, a couple more yesterday and one more today. So I'm pretty much loaded for bear, as the saying goes. I think we have the ability to probably get back down to the maybe 1920 level on the S&P cash.
Okay. Well, thank you.
You bet. But even if we just did okay, you should get a retrace, and that would be where you want to look at it and see that it comes in on light volume. 452 to 468, it would be a great place to buy that on light volume.
Okay, I appreciate that.
You bet. You can be like Steve. Give me a call at 877-927-6648. Of course, I have my email system too, and you can always email me at path at tfnn.com and have that. Anyway, what else do we have out here to do? Oh, let's take a look at a few of these stocks and how they are doing after the bell. Amazon, let's see what this does getting up here at about 680. Still in this gap. Let's take a look at this. This gap, pretty much. This gap, Amazon gapped down the 4th of January. It did so with 9 million shares. I bet we're going to have a lot more volume than that. But really, what was the low or the close that day on the 31st? 675.89, and you kind of need to get over that. What I disliked about some of the ways that the stocks acted today were stocks like Facebook. Let's take a quick look at that. I think it's up a little bit after hours. One thing I disliked is you had all this volume today in many stocks, and by the end of the day, they closed back in their trading range. On Facebook, the February 2nd high was 117.59, and you had 59 million shares. You had 86 million shares. It could not hold above that previous high. In fact, the close was 116.73. I think it's up about 117.50 the last I looked, after Amazon and a few others out here. But it's very important for this thing at least to carry and hold this gap for just a few more days before this thing comes out. And, of course, any more weakness would be a problematic. Let's go to Gilead very quickly, GILD. What else do we have out here? Last 91.96. This thing had already started down. 91.26, I don't see a whole lot in here. It didn't have a good day. The high of the day was 175. The close, 96.98. And I'm going to continue to see problems with Expedia. Gilead. Expedia is the next one. We'll take a quick look at this. Of course, you can EXPE. You can give me a call at 877-927-6648. Gilead, Expedia closed at 107, up 10%, 118.23, right at the previous high. So I'm wondering if this isn't going to be the pattern we see in our earnings, which is you go up to the previous high, you have a lot of volume, but you're not able to hold it. So tomorrow, Friday, going to be a little lighter of volume, but you kind of have to look at this coming into that March 14th high tomorrow and see how that all works out. LinkedIn, LNKD. A lot of moving parts out here after the bell tonight. What else? Closed at 123, last one 34, up almost 11 bucks. Most of these, we've had kind of a decent pattern, and that is stocks that have already been beaten down, kind of coming up, those priced for perfection, kind of missing. What is it, 134, you know, you're just back into this gap. The gap down on February 5th had 44 million shares. Yeah, man, you're going to have a lot of volume. Today we had 4.7 million shares. So you do pop up. You do get a lot of movement out here. And, you know, what are you going to do with it? Normally what I will look for is one of these big gaps is for it to fill about half of it before I even think about pulling the string short on it again. And I have a feeling that a lot of people that were short this thing were betting for the end of the world probably wish that they could do that too. Let's see if we can't narrow this down just a little bit and put some retracements on it. You know, longer overall, you've got a nice confluence level that runs about 159.42 to 166. My guess is there's a few gaps that go way back on that, just above that. But that's probably, you want to see this thing into that level before you would ever have pulled the trigger short again. Now I'm seeing this is at 128 on LinkedIn, so off a little bit about what it is. That's the problem. You've got everybody and their dog on this thing just above and a little higher trying to figure out what they're going to do. See if we've got a Western Digital. Oh, we're going to the break. Make sure and give me a call, 877-927-6648. Email me at PATH, P-A-T-H, at TFNN.com, or post a message in the den.
If-
If you're looking to discover a new financial resource and diversify your financial portfolio, don't miss out on the Market Safe Commodity Solution CD from EverBank. This is the second running of their popular 5-year U.S. dollar denominated CD, which gives you exposure to 8 equally weighted commodities, including WTI crude oil, gold, silver, copper, nickel, soybeans, corn, and sugar. With annual pricing caps of 70% per component, you could earn up to 70% upside payment at maturity if the commodities increase in value across annual pricing dates. And should the opposite occur, your principal is 100% protected. Keep in mind, returns are based on CD performance. There's no annual percentage yield or periodic rate of interest on this indexed CD. Don't miss out. Take advantage of this financial resource designed to grow with the times. The May 19th funding deadline is quickly approaching. So hurry over to everbank.com/TFNN for the CD's term sheet and other important product details and disclosures. Once again, that's everbank.com/TFNN. This advertisement is sponsored content. EverBank is a member FDIC.
Tom O'Brien's weekly gold letter, The Gold Report, gives complete and concise coverage of the entire gold market. Inside, you'll get Tom's commentary on gold, the dollar, the rand, the bond, the XAU, the HUI, and detailed coverage of nearly 25 mining stocks. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock trade. The Gold Report is a long-term newsletter where the focus is on building real wealth through the management of a successful portfolio of gold stocks. With a lifetime of knowledge and almost 12 years of writing his informative weekly newsletter, The Gold Report, Tom O'Brien can provide you with the important market information to help you make better trades in the gold market. Don't let the next bull run in gold pass you by. To get a month-long free trial to The Gold Report, an $85 value, visit the front page of TFNN.com today.
It's 2016 and TFNN has a brand new programming lineup to kick things off. Starting January 4th, Swim Lessons by Thinkorswim and TD Ameritrade will be airing 5 days a week at noon Eastern Time. Join hosts Scott Connor, Kevin Hinks, and Cindy Faber as they host their daily options program live at noon 5 days a week with no commercials for the entire hour. Nico DeHaan and Paige Clark will be moving their program, Living a Primal Lifestyle, to twice a week, Tuesdays and Thursdays from 7 a.m. until 8 a.m. Eastern Time. Wake up with Nico and Paige and start your day off right. The Bull Bear Binary Option Hour by Nadex will now be live Mondays and Fridays at 10 a.m. Start and end the week with the three hosts, Tom O'Brien, Tommy O'Brien, and Daryl Martin, as they break down the world of trading binary options and spreads. For all the details on the new 2016 programming lineup, visit the front page of TFNN.com. TFNN, educating investors.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
And in the Tiger's Den, we've got Andy Heck checking in. He'll be in at the 5 o'clock hour talk technology. And of course, he's got a big course starting May 4th, which is next Wednesday. You want to check that out. The 12 essentials for trading commodities. And that's a mouthful. But check that out on the front page of TFNN. And of course, in his 5 o'clock hour when he wraps up commodities, I have tons of equities to wrap up. So we will continue looking at this. Of course, Apple was down today. You know, it was weak already. We had a great deal of hoopla with Carl Icahn, brother Carl, telling everybody about how he is out of the stock and the reason why. We talked about that at the beginning of the show. But a lot of pin action going on in Apple. Skyworks Solutions. Kind of interesting today in what it was doing. I think it's down a couple of bucks after hours tonight, too. Of course, they make a great deal of the chips or mini chips that go in the iPhone out here. Also problematic. So when we get in the morning, probably going to see continued weakness around the Apple ecosystem and more of the semis. And it looks like those websites that are pure play websites, Facebook, LinkedIn, other ones like that seem to be getting all the love. Companies with hardware, companies that are actually software sales seem to be a little weak out here. See if we've got anything else. I wanted to see if we got anything from Western Digital yet on the blower. It's off a little bit. We'll take a quick look at it. Of course, I do the Tech Insider, which you can find on the front page of TFNN, the weekly newsletter of technology. It's been kind of a sideways market for technology for a while. We're finally starting to bust out of that range. Western Digital didn't do much today. Got to a and basically got to a 618 retracement, which was 47.15. Got a little over that and threw it today. It is off 3% at 44.50. Continues to be a problematic. You could make a case that if this sticks in the morning, that this is the next ABC down. And we will get this back up here. And what do we got? And of course, let's get back to Western Digital. There we go. You could make a case that this isn't the ABC down in Western Digital. If we set that as the A, that 3983 is the B, and that is the C point, the high of today. Yeah, you got a 65.4% retrace off that 3983 low from April 15th. But that does set up a one-to-one at $35.73. Those that took my Tech Insider newsletter knew that we were shorting this thing back up when it was 110, 115, and got the lion's share before on the way down on this one, mostly because of the change in the industry, but we saw it coming way long far away on this one. We had a ton of stocks today also moving, and we want to get into those. For those people that did not catch the show earlier, Silicon Graphics ended up off 34%. And, of course, Infinera, which is INFN is the symbol on that, off about 23%. Not a stock a lot of people talk about. Let's take a quick look at that one, INFN. This company makes a lot of the equipment for cross-channel, across the seas, between continent, fiber optic internet and mesh internet. So these guys sell a lot of cable and a lot of other stuff. Kind of blew down with huge volume on this. Kind of looked at it in the 2 o'clock hour a bit, but all the way back into some gaps. And this thing actually was a three-gap play. It's finished filling this first gap. It's now getting into this third gap. My call on this one would be filling this gap all the way back down to about the $6.50 level on this. So keep an eye out on this one. Not exactly sure why it ran up, but man, this one has a great deal farther to fall. You can see the first gap that it filled comes back to the 23rd of January. This second gap that we're into right now is the 23rd of October of 2014. And the last gap that this thing looks like it's going to come back and fill is is January 30th of 2014. So you've got a three-gap play setting up on this. If you're interested in finding out about that, if you just Google three-gap play, you'll see a white paper on it on TFNN. You can also email me at path@tfnn.com. And, of course, I'll send you the link to that on that. Had some emails here during the break about the other pattern we've been talking about on my daily show, which is the double repo pattern. We've got a lot of these stocks that actually set up that way. I've got a couple minutes since don't have a lot of time on Tom's show anymore, since we don't do a 4 o'clock hour on Fridays anymore. We will talk about this for just a little bit. Early on in TFNN, there was I'm going to say early on because it's been 15 years ago now. Joe DiNapoli, a big trader, And a guy that actually was one of the first quants that used home PCs, in this case CPM PCs, to look at the market, had a pattern that he called the double repo. That was 10 to 15 days trending above his 3x3 displaced moving average, which is pretty close to a 9-day moving average. A few days below it, a close back above it. And then if you get a close back below that 9-day moving average, basically, boom, boom, the lights go out. You tend to fall apart. We've got I'm tracking maybe a couple hundred of those patterns right now. It doesn't happen very often, but it certainly is something that you want to look at. We've talked about it quite a bit on many stocks. In fact, we will go back here and get a couple of these, I think, if I've got time before the end of the show. We'll look at a few more of these. But you get these very quick moving markets where these things just stay above the moving average for a great deal of time. And well, let's look at some of these other ones here. Come on, Alexion Pharmaceuticals. I need you to come up. Of course, the internet's fairly long. What the deal is, though, is that we went on this pattern and it wasn't 10 or 15 days. It was 20. 25, 30, 35 days above a moving average. So when we look at these things, a lot of them, like Abbott Laboratories, went back all the way to mid-March. Some even much longer than that. Some back into February, some into the end of January. The problem is, once these things break these trends, this is the definition of a parabolic move and how these stocks drop off the end. And we'll talk more about these when we come back.
TFNN is excited to offer a brand new piece of market scanning software unlike anything the industry has ever seen. John Logan and his team have spent years developing their market profile tools to finally be able to release the TAS Profile Scanner Plus. And right now, you can get a 2-week trial absolutely free just by visiting TFNN.com and providing us your name and email address. The TAS Profile Scanner Plus is the premier market profile-based scanner in the industry, powered by the acclaimed TAS proprietary algorithms. This feature-rich scanner is a standalone desktop software that instantly filters over 2,500 global financial markets such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Within 3 minutes of signing up, you can have the software downloaded and running on your computer with a complete roadmap of market indicators and inflection points to trade off using the TAS Profile Scanner Plus. Sign up today and try this amazing piece of software by visiting TFNN.com.
Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion. While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a 2-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your 2-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, the opening call, today by visiting TFNN.com.
Hi, I'm Steve Rhodes, host of The Trader's Edge, heard daily at TFNN.com and author of Mastering Probability, a daily investment and trading newsletter service that I send out each morning by 8 a.m. My morning newsletter service covers exactly what the markets have been doing since last night's close, providing you with an edge on your trading day ahead. You get actionable trading ideas, including the exact entry, stop, and profit targets. Plus, I'll teach you the patterns and hidden market correlations that will make you a better trader. As a subscriber, you'll gain access to my 90-minute money management workshop, where I'll teach you the secrets that'll save your assets. The bottom line, I've got your back, including a 30-day money-back guarantee. See for yourself the type of analysis I provide each trading day by signing up for Mastering Probability today. With nothing to lose, this is an offer you should not pass on. Mastering Probability can be found under trading newsletters on the front page of TFNN.com.
phone calls now. Toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Tom O'Brien.
And this is Dave White sitting in for the one and only Tom O'Brien. We'll do a little bit of a catch-up out here. S-Y-N-A. We'll take a quick look at Synaptics. It looks like the loser, and it gets the losing horn for after hours. Off 10%, down almost 10 bucks out here. Of course, kind of a gappy stock to begin with, that'll put it at about 70 bucks. This is going to go after the low that we've had on 70, what is that, March 28th. That only had 1 million shares. If this holds up tomorrow, you can look for a break of that, and it would take you back down into the $65 level, which is the January 29th low back there. So a big mover in that. The others that we already talked about, last on Expedia, it's up 12 bucks at 120. Gilead Sciences down 6%. Last is 90.90. And Outer Wall used to be Redbox, the company that sells the change machines in Walmarts and other big stores like that up front. And of course, the kiosk for the DVDs. It's actually up 10%. Its last was at 44 bucks. Now, again, this is the pattern right now, and that is the stocks that got creamed last quarter are up a little bit. 44 bucks on Outer Wall would just take you to the April 27th high yesterday. So not a big move, but a great deal of these stocks having continued issues. If this thing would move back under that 9x9 moving average, you would want to take a look at it. As we said on my show for the last couple of weeks, we've been talking about this pattern, and that is the double repo pattern, which is a good explanation of stocks that tend to be in a parabolic move. There used to be a signal called the PSAR, the parabolic SAR. It never worked as well as this one, so I kind of abandoned it almost 15 years ago. If you've got a 9-day moving average or a 3x3 displaced moving average on your charts, or maybe something like the Art of Timing the Trade charts, you will find it already in there. In Amgen, we'll see just how some of these other stocks happen. You want, of course, those moves to be 10 to 15 days above the moving average, a close below it for a couple of days maybe, close above it for a couple of days. The next move underneath that is the break. What we've been having are these stocks that haven't gone up for 10 or 15 days, but 20, 25, 30. And as soon as they break under any kind of moving average, these things are tending to crater. Some of these biotechs like Amgen's go back to the mid part of March above this without any kind of significant retrace. We continue to see other stocks in that same vein. Let's take a look at some of these other ones that have been up here. Ones that look like they're giving a signal now and today, you got the close underneath it for J&J. Now, again, this thing has been above its 9-day moving average since middle of February. I'm thinking that these things we really haven't had. I went back and looked over the last couple of days. We really haven't had these kind of moves that have lasted forever. You've always had some kind of volatility in these moves up. This is kind of a rare duck in the way that we have seen this market move up from the February and January lows in most of these things and just continue up and up and up with very light volatility, just up a little bit more the next couple of days. Got a little bit of a bounce in J&J on the 19th of April, but now you've had a solid close below it. You know, I'm not saying pull the trigger on these, but if you get a close above it and then one back down below it, you're going to have some pretty powerful confirmations. Generally, what happens in this double repo pattern is that once it confirms, you move back to wherever it started. In this case, that would be back to the 16th of February for Johnson & Johnson, and that would take you back to the close of 102 on that 16th of February day. So we'll continue. We'll look at a couple more of these as we go on. Of course, we got housing numbers out this morning. They were a little bit disappointing for some things. USG, which makes wallboard, drywall board, it's been on a tear. And you can kind of make an argument this thing has been in that tear since the 17th of March. You got the close down below it today. You got a spike high. You get a little bit of movement back above and then back below. That would bring these back to about $22 on USG, which is the 17th of January. Anyway, what else do we have out here? Facebook After Hours is just hanging up at the levels that we talked about. Tomorrow, what I'm going to be watching is whether or not Facebook can hold this high. That is the February 2nd high at 117.59. It closed under that today. It had all the volume it needed to stay above it, but could not. Now, does the market pull back and Facebook actually come and fill this gap? Was this a one-day wonder of squeezes? I think we're going to learn a great deal more about the market in the coming days for that. We looked at Synaptics. Do we have anything else? Gilead, we looked at that. Let's look at some of the stocks that I've been into. There are a great deal of them out here that have been testing highs or lows, and I wanted to see how they were doing. Covered this on the show today, but Belden Cable, especially after the way that we talked about that Inferia Corporation down 22% today, didn't seem to affect Belden that much, but they're kind of in that same business, big cable manufacturers and labelers. You had a kind of a big gap down that set the gap up for Belden, BDC. That's the July 30th hammer, 2.4 million shares. Got into it with 270,000 shares on October 30th. We've been kind of creeping back up on this for a while. This is going to probably tell us a great deal about how industrial manufacturing is going on. Earnings on this one are on the 4th. But the reason why I bring this up, of course, is that besides the GDP numbers that came out this morning that were, they said earnings were half, GDP was up 0.5%. I think that's probably fairly, generous. I suspect if we dug into the numbers for the government, we'd find out that we were down 0.1%. I think we've been in a very minor recession. I don't expect that it's going to be that big, but I have a feeling that with the PEs running anywhere from 18 to 22 forward in a lot of these companies, it's going to be very hard for the overall market to stay up in the next couple of quarters. Maybe by September, maybe by the time the election is over, we get a lot more. There's a few things out here that I'm looking at. Belden is one of those companies that maybe I'm not trading. Certainly I am looking at it as a canary in the coal mine. What do these guys say on the 4th? What does that tell me about technology and how much cable's being laid for the internet and pushed around? We're going to break when we come back into the home stretch, waiting on with bated breath. I put a worm on my tongue. That is the bated breath for Andy's show starting at 5:00. In the meantime, get ready for the last of what's going on here.
Larry Pesavento has just started his brand new service, Fibonacci 24/7, and he's already delivering content to his subscribers on a daily basis when the market's opened and even on weekends. Each Monday, you'll receive Larry's written report that provides detailed commentary and a summary on the charts and videos that Larry sends out. And throughout the week, when warranted, Larry will send out via charts or videos or both the key markets that he is watching during the day. This will be up-to-the-date active trading information that will
will help you in your daily trading. In Larry's first week alone, he sent out 25 charts, 6 videos, and a full report to his subscribers in just 1 week. If you're a technical trader that uses patterns and retracements to trade, then Larry's service Fibonacci 24/7 is something that you must try. Right now, new subscribers can get a full 30-day money-back guarantee. With nothing to risk, sign up now to Larry Pesavento's Fibonacci 24/7 by visiting the front page of TFNN.com under Trading Newsletters. David White's newsletter, The Technology Insider, is focused like a laser on finding the next big things in technology. If you had invested only $10,000 in Microsoft in 1986, you'd have been a millionaire by 2000. Disruptive technology like Microsoft's is the key to these massive long-term profits, and The Tech Insider is the vehicle from TFNN to capitalize on these opportunities. This is the go-to newsletter that identifies, monitors, and profits on mostly little-known cutting-edge companies with great long-term prospects. David's experience is as an inventor of Emmy-winning animation products for TV and Hollywood that propelled a company public. Match that with 14 years as a full-time trader, and he's uniquely qualified to guide you through the light-speed world of ever-evolving high-tech. If you're ready to ride the next big technology bull market for less than $40 per month, log on to TFNN.com and get your 2-week free trial to the Technology Insider. Get in on the ground floor of the next big thing today. Tiger Real Estate Opportunity Fund is currently offering 4-year first mortgages on many of the fully renovated properties that it has purchased. The first mortgages are third-party appraised with a maximum loan-to-value ratio of 70%, providing a secured investment that pays a fixed return of 5% annually, which works out to a monthly income of more than $416 per $100,000 investment with your principal intact and secured. These 4-year first mortgages are perfect for anyone looking for a secured investment that provides monthly income, much like a CD. For more information, email tigerfund@tfnn.com or click on the Tiger Real Estate Opportunity Fund banner along the right side of the tfnn.com homepage, or call our office directly at 877-518-9190. There's a limited supply, so act now.
Join Andy Hecht as he shows you how to make money in commodities. The Commodities Hour, next on TFNN.
And we've got a little more up here. Baidu's up about $6. We'll take a quick look at that. Again, if you have any questions, you can always email me at path@tfnn.com. I answered some email during the break. So you're back up here to the just a little over the April 14th high on Baidu. Earnings been pretty much decent tonight. Most of them on the plus side, besides Gilead. Of course, the IBB had been kind of weak over the last few days. Kind of interesting to see that kind of roll over. It got to this little gap that it had on the gap down that's kind of remained open from the 15th of January. That's been acting as resistance. It got up there. Volume was at maximum volume was about 4.6 million shares, maybe, if you want to look at the 6th of April. But it's been rolling down. Volume's been pretty consistent out here. Going to be interesting to see what Gilead does to that in trading tomorrow. Many people talking about what will happen tomorrow in trading. And the question is, how many of these stocks do break these trending timelines with being on the 9-day or 3x3 displaced moving average? We're going to get our first break of that. Normally, those are pretty hard. You get a move back up to maybe something like a 9-day, and then you get to pull the trigger again. So there are a lot of stuff going on, a lot of moving pieces as we get through the rest of the day. Just seeing anything else out here moving before we get through. We got about 3 minutes to go. Any requests in the den, make sure to put them in there. But that's been it. We've got a few more. Win, let's see, WINN. I'll take a quick look at this one. As we said, Wynn Resorts, like a lot of these, it's not doing anything after hours. What I was very interested in is how this is pretty much broken. And almost all these stocks have gapped down once they've closed back under. But a lot of these things are finally confirming a top in these parabolic moves and so many days above a 9-day moving average or a 3x3. This one goes back to the 12th of February. So why this thing's at $90? I think earnings tomorrow. I think so. Earnings date, 29th? April 28th. Okay. Maybe it's after the bell tonight, and I just haven't seen it. I don't see anything moving out here. I thought it was either tonight or tomorrow morning. I don't see any numbers on it. Maybe somebody has it. That is the problem. If these things break, you want to look back at the last time these things really took off above the 9-day moving average. And if they've spent this many days above it, we're actually looking at coming back into those levels. So a great deal of stocks kind of setting up that. IYF is our last request for the day. IYF, we'll get to before the end of the show. This is another one I think has a very big ability to roll over here today. We did get a close under the 9-day on this one. This one, it's had a few days underneath it. It's been one of the weaker stocks out here. We've been watching it. There's a stock in that sector I'd like to short. It kind of reversed today also, so I'll see how it trades tomorrow. I'm pretty much 100% short now. Maybe I'll look at pushing that just a bit, but certainly looks fairly interesting. You got your close underneath that today. What we're looking for tomorrow is confirmation in a great deal of these stocks, and that is just to close back below its 9-day moving average on so many of these that have been riding this thing since February, some since January, and some since mid-March, but a great deal of them, 20, 30, 40 days above it. That is the definition of a parabolic move, nothing but up. Hang on for the one and only brother from another mother, Andy Heck, and his Commodities Hours. See you tomorrow.